Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for all of the many blessings that we have received from you, whether those blessings come in times of joy or in times of difficulty, whether they are private blessings or blessings that we share with others, whether they are anticipated or found where we least expect them. Thank you that your blessings, your grace, and your love do not depend on our circumstance, but are freely given to each one of us. Lord, may we never lose sight of the ways in which you bless us. We ask that today, in this place, we will know your presence with us, and that you will speak to us through scripture and through music. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you.
song, isn't it? And beautifully sung, so we thank Gemma. Oh, thank you, Andrew. I was going to say, was that a mouse? But no, it was you. Now, we have a sort of major work for you this evening, and it is entitled Vita Mea Domino, which means My Life to the Lord. We're very, very blessed that Richard Phillips writes a lot of music for us. And this is the latest work that he has written. And it's based on a very well-known tune, Randolph. Now, I guess lots of you will know about Ralph Vaughan Williams. No? Yes? Well, Graham's nodding, so it must be okay. But Vaughan Williams has written lots and lots of pieces of music that you would know, Fantasia on Green Slaves, and the theme of Thomas Tallis, all manner of symphonies, wonderful G minor mass, a vocal piece. But he was also really interested in writing hymn tunes, and there are some glorious hymn tunes, of which Randolph is one. Now, I thought it might be helpful if Andrew just reminded us what the tune Randolph is. That tune was originally written to go with the words, God be with you till we meet again. Is that a song you would sing here? Many of us behind me and myself have been in school assemblies, and when everybody's finishing school, not a dry eye will be in the house when God be with you till we meet again, when young people are going off on the next stage of their journey. So it's a really, really poignant piece of music, but we use it often in the army with the words, take my life and let it be. And those are the words that we will be referring to tonight. Now, this piece comes in three sections. It's basically quick, slow, quick. It's a little bit more complicated than that. But I thought it might just help for you to hear some of the themes to look out for. So at letter D, we have the gentleman singing a little bit about the lost and the lonely are broken. Goes on to talk about heavenly grace, and it's interesting that the bit about heavenly grace is very chromatic. There's a lot of things going on because it's actually, I suppose, explaining it's not always that easy to accept that grace, and it can be complicated along the way. Well, the middle section is much calmer, and just before we sing that song, Randolph, there's another very sort of reflective part, which is all about all I have and all I am is yours, Lord. And so we reflect, and then we get to the main tune. The third section is an allegro vivace, and you've got a lot of kind of 3-8-6-8 stuff going on, and it talks there about, hear me, O Lord, freely I want to give all there is of me, and it's full of all sorts of energy. But it's still quite tricky, because actually it's not always plain sailing, is it? I thought it might be useful to just reflect on the words of the song that this work is based on, and Tom's going to read that for us now.
Take my life, and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my moments and my days. Take my hands, take my feet. Take my voice, take my lips. Take my silver and my gold. Take my intellect, take my will. Take my heart. Take my love. Take myself, and I will be ever only all for thee. Amen.
Vita mea Domino.
Love.
Thrilling words and a really exhilarating piece of music. So thank you for listening to it, so intently and so appreciatively. There are all sorts of different occupations going on here behind me. We've got people in education, people in finance, people who even work for the army. Not very many, I have to say. But people do other things. But we've also got within here, do you get any British television programs over here? Do you get a program called Doc Martin? Yeah, you like it. Well, we have our own Doc Martin because he's not in the TV show, but he works at the Bodleian Library at Oxford, and he's great with maps. If you want to know anything about maps or getting anywhere, Martin is your man. And we never get lost if Martin is there. But he just, a couple of weeks ago, lent me a book. And it is a book of musical crits by George Bernard Shaw, the person who wrote Major Barbara. And it's really interesting. There's a little bit about, well, actually, there's a reasonable amount about the ISB, and there's a little bit about the original staff Songsters, which actually started at the beginning of the 1900s. If you want to know what he says about the ISB, see me later. But if you want to know what he said about the ISS, he talked about the fact that actually it'd be great if they did more unaccompanied singing. And it's something that I have a real passion for. It's going to be really hard after that piece, isn't it, ladies and gentlemen? But there is just something very compelling about the human voice. And the piece we're going to sing for you now is called Ubi Caritas. And what the words mean are that wherever there is love, and there is a feeling of family and support, that is where God is. There will be a kind of translation going on as we sing, but I hope you enjoy this, and I hope that it's going to work in your beautiful chapel here. Ubi Caritas.
Thank you.
Where charity and love are. Sorry, were you going to say something?
I was.
Oh, sorry.
This is Tom, you'll meet him later. However, you're now going to meet Hazel.
So as I was saying before I was rudely interrupted, my name is Tom, and I've been singing with the Staff Songsters for about 2 years now. I think considering what's just happened, this might be my last concert with the Staff Songsters. So I'm going to take as long as I can to talk to you tonight. I've been really enjoying the tour so far. One of my favourite things about singing with the Staff Songsters is being able to travel around the United Kingdom and Ireland territory. We've been to the Denmark territory, we're now in your lovely territory here, and seeing different expressions of Salvation Army and how we can work in our local communities. It's really brilliant to see. And when I go to places, I like to try and find out some special facts about that place. Now, I do have a bit of an issue with Royal Oak. I thought we were going to Detroit, and as I found out today, Royal Oak is not Detroit. So unfortunately, I don't have any facts for you. It's not going well, is it? So I thought to make it up to you tonight, we're going to do something extra special. Does that sound good to you? So we are going to break a world record tonight. Are you with me? Now the thing is, when we did our last weekend in the UK at Leek, they were very enthusiastic about that, and they did actually break the world record. So we need a bit more enthusiasm. Are you ready to break a world record tonight? Oh, we even had a whistle. That's fantastic, because we are breaking the world record for the most CDs sold in a 10-minute period. We have just released our new CD, Alpha and Omega, and it's really appropriate for our Songs of Love tour, because this is a CD that is all about God's love. God's love from the beginning of time to the end of time, from Alpha to Omega. Throughout our tour, we have seen God's love in action. We've experienced his presence. We started off our tour in an adult rehabilitation center in Chicago, where we had these poor men who were really struggling to get to grips with life, and one of them actually said, "I know God believes in me. I just wish I could believe in myself." We've experienced God's presence in our fellowship on the coach, experiencing different types of food together. We had a Detroit-style pizza today, which, is there anyone from Chicago here? Okay, I'll keep quiet about which pizza I preferred then. I've learnt my lesson. When we were in Chicago, Lieutenant Colonel Barbara Rich said, "Music is meant to be shared, not performed." And this is our way of sharing our music with you tonight. So they're on sale at a table out in the back. We've got this CD available for $20, and some of our more recent CDs available for $20 as well. That's Lord, You Are the Song, and Blessings, and then some of our old favourites for $10 each. And I think maybe if you speak nicely to them, they may be able to do you a deal and throw in some goodies in there as well. But you may tell from us, we're a very mission-focused group. We believe that music is a powerful tool for bringing people to Jesus Christ. Do you agree? So when we came here, we said, we know we're going to have an impact at these concerts, when we lead meetings, but we want our impact to be more than that. So we took some time and thought about it and said, what can we do? Now, stick your hands up, ISS, if you have been to some form of music camp in the UK. Can I just have hands up in the audience as well? Has anyone been to a music camp or a music school? Now, keep your hand up if you feel that God has spoken to you during those times at a music camp. Yeah, I thought that might be the case. God has a real talent for reaching out to young people at these music camps. They take place all across the globe. So we thought, what can be more powerful than giving the gift of music, of sending a young person to a music camp? But we can't do this ourselves, and this is where you come in. So do you want to join us in our mission? Yes, that's great to hear. So, I think you were more enthusiastic about breaking the world record. So tonight we also have some limited edition goodies that we are giving out for any donation, whatever you feel. It can be coins, but if it's paper, that's even better. The more impact we can have. So we have some lovely ISS pins, and especially for this tour, they are limited edition. So once they are gone, they are gone. We have some ISS pins with our new gold logo on. And I'd encourage you, get one of these and wear them. Show everyone that you are joining with us in our mission. Show us that you are making a real difference in the lives of young people in this amazing country. Where charity and love are, God is there. We're going to finish our second half with two special songs. First half. And I was doing so well. But it was a real privilege to come together and share in worship in a massed Songster rehearsal earlier today. And we're going to have that item now. So if you took part in that rehearsal, if you'd like to come up and join us. And considering all my blunders, I will let Dorothy introduce these next two items.
So the first song we're going to sing together is a beautiful setting of the words When God Comes Near. Now, many of you will know Bill Himes. He's a great friend of the ISS. But he set words by Major James Burney. And in fact, it was a privilege to work on this song when I was at CMI. But also, it became very special to us in the pandemic. Now, some of us may remember recording pieces of music down phones and trying to put it all together. But these words really spoke to people who listened to that recording. So we'll sing that first. Then the second song we're going to sing requires a bit of audience participation. And he's got the whole world in his hands. Now, we've got all sorts of fancy stuff going on here. Ladies and gentlemen, will you sing the tune with me when it comes to it? We have wonderful friends here from the Canadian Staff Songsters, so I'm expecting great tunes coming from you tonight. And we're very grateful for you traveling all the way. But let's sing, first of all, When God Comes Near.
I'm alone.
Well, that was Elliot. Actually, Elliot is into kind of marketing and advertising in his real life, and he has just set up an Instagram account. Do you want me to just say something about that quickly?
Me.
No, me. Because if you get... so if you want to kind of, you know, have a little look there, he's coming up with some really lovely ideas to just try and communicate what we're all about. We obviously are here at Easter, and at each different event, we're trying to feature a slightly different aspect of the Easter story. We're doing a slightly shorter one than we did at the Croc Center in Chicago, but we thought tonight it was actually still appropriate to be touching on that, and that you would be interested to hear how we've mixed together music and scripture.
After he was flogged, the soldiers took Jesus into the courtyard of the governor's headquarters and called together the entire regiment. And they clothed him in a purple cloak, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him. And they began saluting him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed, spat upon him, and dropped to their knees in mock worship. When they were finally tired of mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to be crucified.
Thank you.
9 o'clock in the morning when they crucified him. A sign announced the charge against him. It read, "The King of the Jews." Two revolutionaries were crucified with him, one on his right and one on his left. The people passing by shouted abuse, shaking their heads in mockery. "Huh, look at you now," they yelled at him. "You said you were going to destroy the temple and rebuild it in 3 days. Well then, save yourself and come down from the cross." The leading priests and teachers of religious law also mocked Jesus. "He saved others," they scoffed, "but he can't save himself. Let this Messiah, this King of Israel, come down from the cross so we can see it and believe him." Even the men who were crucified with Jesus ridiculed him.
Shadow.
Listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth was a man accredited by God to you by miracles, wonders, and signs, which God did among you through him, as you yourselves know. This man was handed over to you by God's deliberate plan and foreknowledge. And you, with the help of wicked men, put him to death by nailing him to the cross. But God raised him from the dead, freeing him from the agony of death, because it was impossible for death to keep its hold on him.
Oh, Just have a few moments to bring you some thoughts this evening. I'm Jane Roberts, and I have the privilege of being the executive officer to the staff Songsters. Now, the last few days, we have had many happy reunions, and I have seen various people in the group greeting family members, greeting friends, but there was nobody I knew personally. Until I came here this evening, and I saw Commissioner Nancy Roberts, and I saw Commissioner Bill Roberts. And they might be Roberts. We're not related. We used to pretend we were distant cousins when we served at IHQ, and that worked for me. But it's so great to be here this evening with all of you, and wherever we go, we are at home with God's people. And the party continues, doesn't it? Easter Monday, and we are still celebrating that Christ is risen. Christ is risen. Hallelujah. God's love is bigger than all that entombs us. God's power is greater than all that entraps us. Christ is risen. Resurrection has surprised us. The tomb is open. Jesus has risen from the dead. Let us stand with those first witnesses and join their deepest joy, the source of love, creator of life, restorer of all things. Christ our Savior is risen from the dead. Hallelujah. Let us take something quite simple but profound from this weekend. We don't come to Jesus. Jesus comes to us. So often we talk about coming to Jesus as though we are the ones who control what happens, but we aren't. Christ comes to us as he did to Mary in the garden. The work of resurrection and transformation lies squarely on his shoulders, and he knows what we need. Nothing is asked of us except a willingness to listen and to be willing to walk with him on a new journey into a new way of life. I look at the disciples, the followers of Jesus, and I'm reminded that Jesus comes to us. The presence of love comes when we are in the place of grief and despair and draws us into the light of a possibility of a shining new day. Change and transformation are possible because Jesus comes to us. And I invite you to just reflect on that as the group brings the beautiful song with the music of George Marshall, Jesus Himself Drew Near.
Thank you.
Beautiful words, aren't they? And they just remind us that in whatever situation we are in, we don't know all the things, all the joys and challenges you have. I guess you don't know all the joys and challenges that we have here. But we all believe that if we ask for help and if we pray, Jesus himself will indeed be near. Now, William Booth used to say, I believe, why should the devil have all the best tunes? And we've just got a little number. You have to tell me, I'll stand at the door in the way. You have to tell me if you think this is appropriate or not. But we're going to do it anyway. And let's see if you recognize it. I'm just kind of covering a bit of chat. I think I can. Okay, then. We might need a note from our maestro over there. Ready? One, two, three.
You can sing, you can praise, serving the Lord all your days. Ooh, he is Lord of everything, he is the coming King. If you're sad and you're feeling low, there is something that you should know.
Jesus knows you and loves you. More than anything, he wants to be your King.
Reaching out to each girl and guy, Jesus love's gonna lift you high.
So let's praise him with music, praise the Lord divine, join in the holy dance. You've got a second chance, he is the coming King. Lord of lords, he is King of kings. Coming King, praise him with drums and tambourines, oh yeah. You can sing, you can praise, serving the Lord all your days.
Ooh,
he is Lord of everything, he is the coming King. To him, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. We're who he's coming for. He is the coming King, Lord of lords, he is King of kings. Coming King, praise him with drums and tambourines, oh yeah. You can sing, praise, serving the Lord all your days.
Ooh,
he is Lord of everything, he is a coming King. He is a coming King. He is a coming King.
I'll come to this one just in case. Well, we're coming now to the end. I was hoping that there might have been an R. if you've got time, I mean, you have to tell, you know, we always finish our festivals with a song called More Than Wonderful. And somebody's already been to check with me, we're singing it tonight. But as long as, if you've got to go, you know, and you've got to catch a bus or get a taxi, whatever it is, do feel free to. But it's just a marvelous song, and it's what we believe. So what we'd like to do is to sing that for you, and then Jane will pronounce the benediction, but then we will come around you because we would like to sing a final benediction for you. You've got a fantastic core here. It's just amazing. And we felt the warmth of your family, your core family. So thank you for the welcome you've given us. And we look forward maybe to seeing some of you again next Saturday or even Friday. Thank you. Good night. Thank you, everybody.
And a final prayer. Heavenly Father, we just thank you so much for your love, for your grace, for the hope and joy that we find in knowing you and loving you and serving you. And I pray that this may be the experience of every person in this hall this evening. And I just ask your blessing upon this wonderful core family here, upon those who have traveled great distances. Lord, bless them and keep them safe on their homeward way. And be with each one of us, we pray, and keep us close to you as you draw near to us. We pray in the precious name of Jesus. Amen.